Blackstone Publishing presents It Never Ends, A Memoir with Nice Memories by Tom Scharpling. This book is read by Tom Scharpling. To Sue and Tom, aka my parents, one is gone, but both of you are with me every day. You make every other so-called parent look like a pile of discarded diapers. Chapter 1. It Never Ends, The Beginning. In the summer of 2019, I was walking around a midtown Manhattan bookstore with my friend Sammy Skolmoski, talking about the book that you're currently reading. Sammy was visiting from Chicago, and we took a night to discuss some of the more philosophical aspects of writing a memoir. Sammy is a very funny writer, and for years she's been saying that I should write a book. As much as I fantasized about someday becoming an author, I never felt ready. A book is supposed to be a work of art, I would insist. Have you actually seen the kinds of books that get published? She would counter. Yes, I know that football bro Rob Gronk Gronkowski is a published author. And Kiss bassist Gene Simmons has slapped his name on a half dozen bestsellers. But I grew up worshiping books. If I was ever going to write one, it would need to be great. I'd rather die than have my name barfed onto the cover of one of those tomes with huge type that far too many comedians churn out. There was a point where famous people would compile their tweets into books. Charging for tweets! The hubris! People in my life would gently remind me that I needed to stop complaining about the ocean of undeserving clowns who proudly call themselves author. Instead of moaning, it was my turn to become one of those clowns. I thought about it for another 2 years. I'm sometimes slow with making decisions. You'll see that that's a running theme throughout this book. Before I finally acquiesced. So what made me change my mind? One day while floating around a bookstore, I decided to check out the new releases table. And sitting front and center was a self-help manual by DJ Khaled called The Keys. I never picked up the book, but I'm assuming it consists of pages written by other authors with an occasional DJ Khaled typed at the start of every chapter. This was the moment I knew I had literally nothing to lose. If that buffoon could write a book, I could write a book. It was time for me to tell my story. While I've read more than a million books, mostly rock and showbiz biographies, I had never actually written one, so I needed some help. Sammy dispensed some serious wisdom as we walked around the Union Square chain bookstore whose name I will not utter. It rhymes with Blarnes and Blobel, and the branch we were in is located a few doors down from the final location of Andy Warhol's factory, which is currently a PetSmart. We talked about the book's title. Sammy wanted to know exactly why I was calling this book It Never Ends. I started to explain myself as we drifted past the psychology section. I caught a glimpse of some of the titles scattered throughout the shelves and stopped dead in my tracks. Look at this, I said, zeroing in on the books. Any of these would work as the title of my book. Some of the titles included How I Stayed Alive When My Brain Was Trying to Kill Me, Maybe You Should Talk to Someone, The Trauma of Everyday Life, Duped, Let Me Not Be Mad, Going to Pieces Without Falling Apart, The Invisible Gorilla, We've Been Too Patient, Are You Okay, Lost at Sea, Good Reasons for Bad Feelings, You Are Now Less Dumb. I turned to Sammy and said, these are all perfectly good book titles, but it wouldn't be the same. I will tell you why I chose It Never Ends, but before I do, this bookstore has one of the only unlocked bathrooms in the city, so I'll be right back. I excused myself and promptly entered the men's room. This particular Blarnes and Blobel featured a restroom that was wide open to any New Yorker with the capacity to pretend they were shopping for a book. Every trip inside this bathroom was a spin of a disgraceful carnival wheel. Where will it land this time? An open issue of Penthouse on the men's room floor? A bare-assed man pissing at the urinal with his pants and underwear lowered around his ankles? Today delivered a special treat. Some mystery person was in the bathroom stall blasting an episode of Joe Rogan's podcast on their phone. I was tempted to knock on the door and ask the listener whether he knew that Joe's website sold Star Wars-related workout equipment like a Death Star slam ball and a Han Solo frozen in carbonite yoga mat, but opted instead to do my toilet business and not court my own toilet murder. I made a quick escape and rejoined Sammy, telling her the tale that led me to call this book It Never Ends. If my stories were songs, this would be one of my biggest hits. It would be my Hey Jude, my Purple Rain, my Despacito featuring Justin Bieber. The best stories feature a bunch of ridiculous elements that line up in a way that creates magic. I have told this tale on the radio, and people love it so much that they regularly throw it.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.